Hey guys, it's Patch. Hope you're doing okay. I wanted to do a video on footwear that's often used on trails, on mountains and things like that. If you're looking at getting into hiking or backpacking, chances are you're thinking about getting a nice pair of comfortable boots like these. This is what most people think of when they think of what they need for hiking or backpacking, and I'm here to tell you that that's not necessarily the case. I'm going to list a few reasons why you may want to go for something like a trail runner, like the Ultra Lone Peak 4.5 or any trail runner. This is just what I have, instead of a boot like this, okay? So the first thing you might want to consider is cost. So a boot like this, you're buying more shoe, essentially. So a boot like this will often set you back £150 to £200, especially if it's Gore-Tex material. Whereas a trail runner like this, these were just over £100, but Ultra is a really decent brand. You can get them a lot cheaper than that. And in any case, you may already have a pair of decent running or trail running shoes already with you. So you might not even have to buy them anyway. So there you go, save some money straight away. Another thing to consider is the weight. So these are actually my girlfriend's, but my boots weigh 650 grams. I'll put the ounces somewhere up here, each. So 650 grams compared to 325 each. So conveniently that's half. So you're saving half the weight on these. People always think it's just the backpack you need to think about, but after a long miles, your legs are going to get tired if you're having to shift double the weight. It might seem negligible now, but it does add up. Another thing to consider is, do you actually need this amount of protection? So these are super comfortable, supportive around the ankle, so you're much less likely to roll your ankle on rocky terrain, when you're mountaineering, etc. And nice hard sole with plenty of grip to avoid getting hurt by rocks or whatever through the foot. Whereas this is obviously below the ankle. It still has a reasonably hard sole, but not as hard as a boot. And there's not much support around the sides. So you need to think about what terrain you're going to be walking on. If you're just going up and down mountains all day, walking over loads of rocks, technical terrain, then a boot like this might be more appropriate. However, what most people do, they stick on a kind of established trail, whether that's gravel or just a dirt track or whatever, in which case this would be more than appropriate. Much more people are moving towards this because the shoe is just much more comfortable as well. Another thing to consider when choosing between these two is how much water you're going to be coming across, because that will have a big effect on you. These types of boots, especially if they're Gore-Tex, are much more protected from water, and they're meant to be breathable as well. This one says waterproof on it. Not sure about how truthful that is, but the thing is, if you're going on a multi-day trip, yes, this might protect you from streams or little puddles or whatever you walk through, especially because it's higher. But your foot's going to be sweating inside. After multiple days, that's a lot of sweat that's going to be getting in your socks, getting on the inside of the boot. And the clincher for this with me is that these do not dry out quickly. You need to use a hell of a lot of newspaper heat, like next to a fire or something, to dry these out. And it's very unlikely that you're going to be able to dry these out overnight if they get wet. So yes, these do protect you from water a lot more, but once they are wet, they're very difficult to get dried out. Compared to these, which do get wet very easily. You see all the ventilation there, water will just soak that up in no time. However, once you're out of the water and walking, the water just gets squeezed out of them and then they dry out nice and quickly. So instead of trying to avoid getting wet by wearing one of these, just accept that you're gonna get wet and that it will dry out much more quickly as you walk, which it does. I've used these for a while and they're much more comfortable. Walk through streams or whatever, no problem. Don't need to avoid it because I know that they're going to dry out nice and quickly once I'm on the other side. Now, last thing to consider is comfort. Obviously, that's one of the main things you want to be considering when you're getting hiking equipment. You want to be comfortable when you're walking as well as when you're at camp. These, for me, just aren't as comfortable as trail runner shoes. They're much more rigid. They don't flex as much. They're usually much narrower in the toes. I usually get blisters on the back of my heel here if I'm walking lots of miles. Because they're just rubbing. There's no flex. They don't move with your foot. Whereas these, they're just much more comfortable. Wear these whenever I can, to be honest. You can imagine that below the ankle, it just gives your foot a lot more freedom. The sole flexes with you, and it's just a much nicer walking experience. There's a few things to consider when deciding between different types of footwear for hiking and backpacking. Cost. What did I go through? Cost, weight, whether the level of protection is appropriate for you, how they deal with water, and general comfort. Okay, if you've got any questions, please put them down below, and I'll do my best to answer them. Please like and subscribe, and wait out for the next video.